Hello children, my name is Narasimhulu. PGT in commerce subject, working in Telangana State Model School and Junior College, Tandu, Vikarabad district. Today I am going to teach you Intermediate Second Year Accounts Unit 4 Partnership Firm Accounts or Partnership Accounts. So here, after completion of this video, you will be able to learn or understand few things and those are the objectives of this lesson. So objectives. So what are the objectives? You just observe in this video. You can go to learn the partnership accounts objectives, introduction, meaning and definition, essential features of partnership, partnership deed agreement, final accounts of financial statements, profit and loss appropriation account, methods of preparing capital accounts, now come to introduction to partnership accounts. Dear students, in the previous year you already studied various forms of business organizations such as sole proprietorship, business organizations, joint Hindu family business organizations, partnership firms, cooperative societies, and finally joint stock companies. You already studied each type of business organization has its own advantages and disadvantages. Here, the limitations of a sole trading organization such as limited capital, limited managerial skills, size of the business organization, etc., or the causes for the emerging partnership firms. You know what is partnership firm? When there are two or more persons enter into an agreement to share profits of a business, then that is called as partnership firm. So the provisions of Indian Partnership Act 1932 are applicable to all partnership business organizations in India. See here in the introduction what is given. In order to eliminate the limitations of sole trading business organizations such as limited capital, size of business, lack of managerial skills, etc., a new form of business organization is emerged which is called as partnership business. So just before I said you how the partnership form, coming to existence. So because of limitations in the soul trading business or organizations. See, in the introductions, what are the points we have to observe? Partnership entity in which partners or owners share profits and losses of the business as per the agreement among them. It is also just before I said, when there are two or more persons enter into an agreement to share profits or losses, so such a business is called as partnership firm. See your last and final point in the introduction. The Indian Partnership Act 1932 contains important provisions which are applicable to partnership firms working in India. I already said the provisions of Indian Partnership Act 1932 are applicable to all partnership business organizations which are working in India. So this is the introduction of partnership firms. Next, you see meaning and definition of partnership firm. So here, in the partnership firm, the members of a business are individually called as partners, and collectively called as firm. And the business carried on under the name, which is called as name of the partnership firm. See the meaning, how it is described. Meaning, the persons who have entered into partnership business are called individually as partner and collectively as firm, and the name under which their business is carried on is called the name of the firm. Just before I told you, children, the persons who are entered into the partnership firm, individually call them as partner, but collectively we can go to call them as firm. Or the name that they use to run a business is called as a the name of the partnership firm. I think it is clear, students. Now see the definition. According to Section 4, Partnership Act 1932, partnership means the relationship between persons who have agreed to share profits of the business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. If you notice the definition, or you can observe the definition, it is clearly given all things in this definition. The relationship between persons. So whatever the relationship they come to established, and between the persons who have agreed to share profits of a business. So the persons whoever enter into an agreement and they agree to share profits or losses which arises from the business organization that is carried on by the partners, by all or one of them on behalf of all. So I hope you understood the definition of the partnership firm. On to next. Essential features of partnership. So if you observe the definition of Indian Partnership Act 1932 Section 4, it's clearly we can go to derive all the features of a partnership from that definition. See what are the features are here. The first one is agreement. There must be an agreement between the partners, whether it may be oral or written. So however, there must be an agreement. So in this agreement, they can go to write all the terms and conditions of the business organization. See next, a business. It must be a lawful business. It includes trade, vocation, and profession. So these partnership organization may run the business. That must be lawful, the first condition. And the business may be either vocation or profession of industry. Profit sharing. The partners share the profits or losses of the business as per the agreement. So whatever the profits or losses that come in the business organization may be shared among the partners according to the agreement. So that is the one of the feature of partnership. Relationship of partners. There will be the principal and agent relationship between or among the partners. So when we talk about relationship among the partners, the relationship generally principal and agent relationship. So sometimes one partner acts as a principal and other partner acts as a agent. Sometimes the same or the person who acts as an agent just before becoming a principal, and another person or another partner who acts as a principal now may act as an agent. So here all partners are principals, all partners are agents. So the relationship among them will be principal and agent relationship. See here next, association of persons. So to form a partnership firm, at least we require 2 members, or we can say minimum number of members is 2, maximum number of members in partnership firm. In case of banking a business, the maximum number of members should not exceed 10. In case of non-banking business, the maximum number of members should not exceed 20. So this is one more feature of partnership firm. Unlimited liability. So the partner's liability will be unlimited. So their personal properties are accountable or used for the payment of the losses arise in the partnership business. Next, partnership deed or agreement. What is partnership deed or what is agreement? Partnership come into existence not from status but from contract, which may be either verbal or written. So generally this partnership never comes from status. It comes from contract. So we already know that to form a partnership firm, we require at least 2 members, and they should make an agreement. So this agreement may be verbal or written. And second, to avoid any misunderstanding among partners, it is desirable to have a written agreement. Suppose if there is a problem arising in a partnership business, to solve that problem the agreement may be helpful for them. If there is no written agreement and there is the chance of growing many misunderstandings among the partners, so it is advisable, it is preferable to have a written agreement in the partnership firm. And see, the written agreement signed by all the partners is called partnership deed. Whenever the written agreement is signed by all the partners are called as a partnership deed. Next, the terms and conditions of partnership agreement. So what are the terms and conditions we can go to see in a partnership agreement? The first one, name of the partnership firm. Name, address, and occupations of all partners. Nature, objects and duration of business. Amount of capital to be contributed by each partner. Drawings, if any, allowed for private purposes. Sharing of profit or loss. Rate of interest on capital and drawings. Rights, duties and liabilities of each partner. Methods of valuation of goodwill and revaluation of assets and liabilities in the event of admission of a new partner or retirement, death of existing partner. Method of keeping books of accounts and audit. Mode of payment to retired partnership or partnership. Next, final account or accounts or financial statements. So what are the final accounts are there? What are the financial statements they use in a partnership firm? You can go to see. First one, like any other forms of business organization, partnership firm also prepare financial statement at the end of the financial year, that is 31st March of each year in India especially, and to know the operational results and its financial position. For the purpose, partnership firm prepares first trading account, next profit and loss account, third profit and loss appropriation account, fourth balance sheet. And see here, additional accounts to be prepared in the partnership firm. What are the, see, if in case of a sole proprietorship business organization, there is only one person or owner. On his name, we can go to prepare only one account and we can go to enter all his personal transactions as well as other transactions in his account. But here, when there are many owners in a partnership firm, so we can go to prepare many accounts and on each partner's name. So what is that? Capital account. Drawings, account of each partner, interest of capital account of each partner, interest on drawings of each partner, in case of partnership business, an account called profit and loss appropriation account is prepared in addition to profit and loss account. So in the business partnership business, we can go to use partner profit and loss appropriation account in addition to profit and loss account. Profit and loss appropriation account. What is profit and loss appropriation account? Profit and loss appropriation account is prepared after ascertaining the net profit or loss through profit or loss account. The profit or loss appropriation account is nominal account in nature. It is an extension of profit and loss account. This account is debited with the interest on capital of partners, salaries, commission, remuneration to the partners, if any allowed, and profit transfer to partnership general reserve. This account is credited with the profit carried from profit and loss account. Interest on drawings, the balance, if any, may be net profit or loss, and will be distributed to the partners as per profit sharing clauses. So this is the specimen of profit and loss appropriation account. So in the debit side, we can go to take in case of loss, there is a opening balance from carry forward from profit and loss account, or in case of profit in the profit and loss account, that can be carried forward to profit and loss appropriation account, that can be taken credit side of the profit and loss appropriation account. See, credit side, interest on drawings, if there are two persons there are two partners in the business firm, then we can go to show it in the credit side. Profit of partner x, interest on drawings, partner y, interest on drawing, interest on drawings, partner x, partner y. Loss, in case of loss, that can be distributed between these two partners. Similarly, come to debit side, interest on capital. Interest on capital X and Y. Partner salary and commission. General reserve. And if there is any balance that can be given to partners. Methods of preparing capital accounts. There are two types of methods to prepare a capital accounts in partnership firms. One is fixed capital account method, another is fluctuating capital method. See what are the fixed capital method. When the partners agrees that the amount of capital contributed by them shall remain fixed, shall not be reduced or increased during the tenure of partnership business, the capital accounts of partner is said to be fixed. Generally, it will be mentioned in partnership deed. So, as per the agreement, partnership agreement, they can prepare fixed capital method accounts where we can't change the amount of capital invested by the partners in the partnership firm. Under this method, capital accounts of partners shows the same balance every year. The adjustments such as drawings, interest on capital, salary or commission to partners, share of profits will be recorded in an account known as current account for each partner. Under fixed capital account method, each partner will have two accounts. They are capital account and current account. A fluctuating capital method. Under this method, all transactions related to partners, such as capital contributed by partners, interest on capitals, drawings, interest on drawings, salaries, commission, share of profits or and losses are recorded in the capital account only. Because of this, the balance keeps changing every year, hence it is fluctuating capital method. Summary. We learnt in this video from the partnership accounts, meaning and introduction of partnership firm, definition of partnership, essential features of partnership, partnership deed, agreement and its content, financial statements, trading account, profit and loss account, profit and loss appropriation account, balance sheet, pro forma of a profit and loss appropriation account, types of capital accounts, fixed capital account, fluctuating capital. Okay, thank you.